G'day and welcome back to Build Some. And in this video, which is the sixth video in my series on the timber framing code or the Australian Standard 1684.2, just want a quick look at the roof load width or RLW. So the roof load width is used as a convenient indicator for the roof loads that are carried by some roof members and load bearing wall members and their supportive or supporting structure. The RLW value shall be used as an input to the relevant wall framing and substructure span tables. So it does depend on what sort of roof construction you have, what your formula is. So we'll go through a few different scenarios, starting with a truss roof. So you have a truss roof and you want to know the RLW at A. What you need to do is take whatever span 1 is, add it to span 3, and divide that by 2. Now you're going to say, well, that's exactly the same as what span 1 is, which it is in this situation, but if for some reason this was an uneven, not the same as span 1, then we'd get a different answer. So span 1 plus span 3, divide that by 2, and then add the overhang on the appropriate side. So in this case we're going to add span 2 in. Now if we do B, then we'd be doing span 3 plus span 1, divide that by 2, and then add on span 4 to get our RLW at B. Remember, we have to find out what the greatest RLW is for our roof and then use that the whole way through. So that's for truss roof. Now we're going to have a look at a cathedral or a non-coupled roof. So in this case, for again starting at A, we're going to do span 1 divided by 2 plus span 2 will give us the RLW at A. And if we do B, it's span 3 divided by 2 plus span 4. Remember, this is for a non-coupled roof. If we have a ridge support and we want to know what the RLW is at C, then it's span 1 plus span 3, so this span plus this span divided by 2 will give us the RLW at C. Okay, let's go to the next one. For a skiing roof, we want to know the RLW at D. So it's going to be span 1, which is the main span of the rafter, divided by 2, plus the overhang at this end. And if we want to know the RLW at span A, then it's going to be half the span of the main rafter, plus the overhang at this end. So it'll give you the RLW for a skiing roof, again a non-coupled roof. Now we move into our coupled roofs. This one has no ridge supports. So to work out the RLW at A, it is span 1 plus span 2, which is the overhang, will give us the RLW in this situation. And if we go over to B, it's going to be span 3 plus span 4. So that's not a coupled roof, no ridge supports. We throw in a ridge support, then again, for A, it's span 1 divided by 2, because now half the load has been carried by our ridge support, so it's divided by 2, plus span 2, give us the RLW at A. And for B, it's going to be span 3 divided by 2, plus span 4, which is our overhang, to give us the RLW at B. If we go to a coupled roof that has underpurlins, a couple of different scenarios here. Again, this one has no ridge support. So for A, it is span 1 divided by 2, so it's basically that span there, plus span 2. And over on this side where we have multiple purlins, okay, we're going to have span 3 divided by 3, because there are 3 sections, plus our overhang. span 4. Okay. Now, if we were to throw a ridge support into that scenario, we now have span 1 divided by 4. Okay, because this is going to carry halfway down there, and then that's going to get carried by the purlin, and then the other end would be carried by the rest of the way. So span 1 divided by 4 plus span 2. On this side, we have 2 purlins, so it's going to be span 3 divided by 6 plus span 4 will give us the RLW of B in this situation. So what you really need to do is you need to choose the right formula for your situation, and then you can calculate the largest RLW that you have in your roof and use that for your calculations.